Video two, a colleague who shall remain nameless pointed out to me that I missed one very important slang term for money, and that is bacon, as in bringing home the bacon. It's bringing home a paycheck, bringing home the means to eat, in other words. Okay, and I won't tell you who because I didn't ask Miss Stone if I could say it. Oh, I just said her name, Miss Stone. Oh, I did it again. Okay, so financial literacy video two. That was the OJs singing For the Love of Money. And this particular video is about our money system. You can see a picture of our various denominations of money here. But this is what we're referring to. So find these pages in your package and follow along with me. Okay. So money is often referred to as currency, and currency is made up of coins and banknotes. A little aside here, currency and current, in the sense of right now and also in the sense of electricity flowing, they're related terms. Currency is the flow of money, in a manner of speaking. So coins and banknotes have different values. And these values are called denominations. A listing of the denominations in the Canadian money system is next. So here we have the denominations. We have coins consist of nickels, dimes, quarters, loonies, and toonies. And a picture of each is shown below. Here they are, nickel, dime, quarter, loony, and toonie. And then underneath that, the banknotes. The denomination of banknotes or bills are $5, $10, $20, $50, $100, and $500. Images of these bills from $5 to $100 are shown next. Now, I notice there's no $500 bill here. And if we turn the page, you will see that there's no $500 bill here either. I personally have never seen one, never had one. I'm sure they'd be very beautiful. Okay, nice to have. Related values and denominations. Okay, it is important that you are familiar with these denominations and their corresponding values. In order to make purchases and give change, it is essential that you know how the value of each relates to the value of another. Several examples with answers follow. So, number one, what is the value of one set of money in terms of a different denomination? So, if you had one loonie and one quarter and one dime, In terms, how would that, what would that, the value of that be in terms of dollars and cents? In other words, putting it all together. So you have $2, you have 25 cents, and you have 10 cents. Okay, so that would be $2 and 25, 35, 35 cents. And the answer is written right there. Okay, B, 1 loonie and 50 cents in terms of quarters.
Okay.
So we know that $1 is 4 quarters, and 50 cents would be 2 more quarters, so the grand total of dollar, 1 loonie and 50 cents would be 6 quarters. Pretty straightforward.
Okay, what is the total value of each set of money below?
Okay, so here we have pictures of coins. We have to figure out how much they would be, how much the value of them altogether. So we have 2 quarters, a dime, and a nickel. So that's 50 cents, 60 cents, 65 cents. And it's written out two ways. One way with just the cent sign afterwards, 25, 25, 10, and 5 to make 65. Or it also could be written as a decimal, and you don't put anything in front of it. The convention is you don't put anything in front of it until you put the answer. So it's 0.25, 0.25, 0.10, 0.05 equals dollars 0.65, or 65 cents. Okay, and last one on this page, we have a $5 bill, a toonie, and you can tell it's a toonie because it doesn't have the corner cornered off. It's perfectly round. The picture isn't great, but I can tell. So you've got a $5 bill, a toonie, a dime, and a nickel. So that's $5 plus $2, $7 altogether, and 10, 15 cents. So here we have $5 and a toonie and a dime and a nickel would be $5 plus $2, which would be $7, and 10, 15 cents. And there's the answer right there. Okay, now it is your turn. So on this page, these exercises, number one, you are to convert from one denomination to another. How many of each of the following are there? Okay, just put the answers right here, neatly, of course. Number two, what is the value of one set of money in terms of another denomination? Okay, that's pretty straightforward. You add them together and put what they are in dollars and cents, or whatever they ask for, quarters, dollars and cents, quarters, whatever, dimes, whatever. And last but not least, turning the page again, we have a third group, and these are actual coins and banknotes, and you have to say, what is the total value of each set of money? And again, you could just put the answers down here, or in this case, you could just put it under there. If you label every answer properly and carefully, and put your name on every single sheet, then your answers will get credit, and they will all get marked fully. Okay, so that's video 2, and about our denominations, our money system. Next, we have calculating with money. GoPro, stop recording. GoPro, stop recording.